Scene two. A large green pasture with two Nuremberg trees planted right in the middle of the stage. Soldiers from the wings. The entrance of the soldiers. The captain uses his saber to point out Punch to the soldiers. Punch runs away across the stage. The soldiers line up for battle. Sneaks back in. The doll retreats in fear. Punch takes the soldier's rifle. And the flower. And looks laughingly at the doll. Sticks out his head one more time, sneers one last time at the soldier, and leaves. The doll gently approaches the soldier, bends over him, and nurses his wounds. And a sign that reads, "Barn for sale." The curtain rises. The soldier, with one arm in a sling and holding a flower in the other, is alone on the stage with the doll. On his pipes in the distance.
Thank you.
alone on the stage, with their two geese and their two sheep, the soldier and the doll are lulled into the melancholy that seeps into their wooden souls by the sound of the shepherd's pipes. Depart slowly in the direction of the barn. The scene changes with the curtain up. Plumper. Nearby, lined up in order of height, are their children. The doll who can no longer dance is trying to sing. The enthusiastic children dance a well-known polka. Obvious disregard for the intentions of the composer. Same characters. The head of the little wooden soldier appears. He salutes the audience.